In this video, I will show you one of the ways to flung your character when they die or something. I'm going to add a particle, and I'm going to name it Yeet. So the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to set the texture of this particle and then just emit one of it at the exact position where the player is when they die. So if you have never thought of it, you're welcome and you can do it on your own now. But if you need some guidance, you can continue watching. So for now, I'm just going to set the image by myself, give it a material, set the amount to 1, and just play around with the gravity until you find a setting that you like. I'm also going to flung it upwards a little bit, so I'm going to change the direction and then give it a little initial velocity. And I'm going to change its angular velocity to some very wild stuff. That looks cool. And there's this FPS thing. I don't know why this is in here. I don't know why it's 30 by default, but I'm going to use 60 just so that it looks nicer for me. For the lifetime, you can set it to 2 seconds, 3 seconds, however long enough that it will be off screen by the time it disappears. I'm just going to stop it from emitting. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to simulate the dying event. I'm just going to use this. You're probably going to use player death signal or something like that. And for now, I'm just going to hide the player. So I'm going to get Yeet. I'm going to use the function emit particle. And I'm going to use the player's global transform. This looks a little messy. I think the implementation is a little questionable because you see, I'm not modifying any of the three, just this. So maybe it's for when you want to customize a lot of the components, but I think this is a pretty ugly way to do it when you have a lot of components that are probably better default to some values. So now if I run this, I can walk around and assume that a player dies here. There you go. You can abstract this away by saving this as a scene. And I'm going to give it a script. I'm just going to take this over and give it an input for the transform 2D. Now in here, I could just say Yeet and then player transform, like so. I'm going to leave the texture empty and then set it myself. So Yeet texture is player texture. You can set it to whatever you like. Have fun, make games.